Hello, it's the Batman Painter, and today I'm going to destroy these Warhounds from the Legion Imperialis box set, and I'm going to do that by using a brand primer, and I don't know exactly what went wrong, but it crackled, and I should have saved the footage, but I really did try to get the primer off again. Using isopropanol alcohol, but yeah, so I did the best I could, and then I primed it with Lead Belcher instead. It wasn't a Citadel prime. I'm not going to mention the brand because it might have been user error. Probably was, but anywho, it pissed me off. So a quick layer of non-oil, and then the silver is pretty much done on these, which is nice. I'm going to do two different houses. So the first one is what's called Mortier. Yes, probably. Anywho, that's going to be red and black. So I select the panels that I think should be red, and that's a couple of them. And I use Mephiston Red for that. For the yellow, I use Avalon Sunset because it's a dark yellow and it has decent coverage. And I really like that color. And again, with the first couple of layers, I just kind of have to make sure not to to hit the parts that I want to keep metal, which is most of it, but still. And for the red, I use for the black, I use Abaddon Black, and that's going to be the main color for most of the panels. And since I fucked everything up with the primer, I try to use very thin layers. I thin it down severely, and then I add layers as I go. There are some markings on the cover art, so I use masking tape for that. Anywho, Azul Ultramarine, or Ultramarine Blue, from Vallejo, as the blue color for my blue and yellow Warhound. And it's again the same as with the Abaddon Black. I try to thin down the paint so it flows really nicely, and I don't clunk everything up too badly, because everything is kind of clunky already. On the smooth surfaces, I managed to get most of the primer off, but for the really detailed sections, that's another story. Then I go in with Corvus Black and I stipple the black parts, or the black armor plates, and that's just to break up that deep Abaddon Black and add some interest. And for the blue one, I decided to go in with Magic Blue from Vallejo, which is a really bright blue, and when it first came on, I felt like it was too much, but as it dries, it darkens down a little bit, which is good, because I like, mentally I couldn't really, I just couldn't remove another layer of paint and start over. For all the panel lines, edges of the panels, I use Retributor armor this time. I tried using a bronze for the Reaver Titan, and that ended up looking kind of shitty. Retributor armor has really good coverage, so I used that. Now, there are several bronze parts on the weapons and around on the skeleton of these Warhounds. And again, instead of using a bronze, I decided to try to use Cryptic armor to kind of give it that the bronze look, and it worked out okay. I don't think it's going to be my standard approach, but for this it was kind of okay. For the eyes, I gave it a Spirit Stone from Citadel. It's a technical paint that is quite thick, and it dries up kind of glossy, glass-like. So I thought that was a good look for the eyes. And looking at the end result, I feel like this was one of the few things I actually did right with these. For the tips of the missiles, I decided to use Skulker Yellow from Two Thin Coats. It's a bit brighter than Avalon Sunset, but has the same coverage, and finding a yellow that actually covers nicely is difficult, so that's why the choice went on that. For the wires, I go back with Corpus Black, because it's a rubbery looking black as well, so if you want something to appear as being rubber, it's a good black. And as one of the last things, Reichland Flesh Shade, and that's to shade all the gold, to bring out the details. And again, due to my primer fuck up, some of the details are really obscure already. It doesn't look that bad on video, but if you see it in real life, there are some... you can see it on the leg plate. So I try to bring out some of the details that are quite hard to see now in the current state of things. And it kind of saved it a little bit. It could have been worse. So it's going to be a theme the next couple of videos, me fucking things up and then trying to fix it. I feel like I should probably start including the scraping the paint off part, because I spent a lot of time trying to get that primer off. It's a really good primer because it sure as hell sticks on there. I don't know if it was the temperature or what it was. I didn't add a thick layer, but it kind of pulled together and then crackled. So it looked quite horrible. It was sad. Anywho, I feel like the result was okay, based on what I had to work with. Yeah. I could have done worse. Not a lot worse, but I could have done worse. Anywho, thank you so much for watching. If you, for some reason, liked this video, please leave a like. If nothing else, then do it out of pity. I destroyed two models and made a video about it. Yeah, thank you for your time. I know it's valuable. It's limited. And hopefully I will see you soon for another upload. Bye.